guys, it's Phantom, and welcome back to my channel for another Sims FAQ video. Now, I've been waiting probably far too long to film this video. But since I am re-uploading a video from a couple days ago, I decided to just film this video now so that I don't have to worry about it. Okay, so some of these comments are really old, but some of these comments are barely even new, and some of them are pretty old, but I don't care. Anyway, one question says, did you buy Sims on your phone on Origin and a Sims a CD? Okay, first off, you can't really buy, The Sims is for computers. It's always been for computers. They have free apps, but that's not the point. So, anyway, to answer this question, I technically already replied, but let me explain this in a way that you might understand. You can't really buy Sims. Sims is an app. It's an application, but it's for the compute. It's hard to explain. It's a computer game. That's what I'm trying to say. So, no. You can't really buy this game on your phone. I wouldn't recommend it unless you buy it through Amazon or something. But no, Sims is not made for your phone. Yes, Sims is a CD. Yes, all of the games are pretty much CDs. Some of the packs are digital, so it comes with a code. But, no. Sims isn't really an app, or not anymore. And if you're talking about the app versions of the game, they are pretty bad. So, let me just show you what I mean. So, let's turn on, what is it, display capture? Or window, should we do window capture for this? And it's already on, what the heck? Okay. Sorry. Anyway, so the point of this answer, oops. Sorry. Let me turn window capture on. Let me switch it, I guess. I don't know. It's kind of difficult. Anyway, let me switch it to where you can see. Oh my gosh, I don't know what's going on. Okay, there we go. Sorry about that. I'll fix it. Anyway, hold on. Give me a second. Let me shrink this a little bit so that you can see the whole thing. Pretty good. Okay, so technically, no, The Sims isn't a computer game. You know what I mean? Not a phone game. Or they didn't really make an official app for it, I don't think, but yes, it's a CD, yes, it's a disc. Pretty much all the games are on disc. Some of the expansions are digital. But yeah, I don't really know how to answer that question. this comment talks about someone being locked out of their origin account. Okay, there's like lots of ways that you can fix this, but let me read the comment. It said, "Hi, I somehow can't log into my origin account on the website. Let me just tell you, sometimes the, it depends on how you log in. Like, if you log in on the website through a phone, it can be, or like a mobile browser, it can be glitchy and might not work properly. Someone also said that they can't find any of their games, like their game library is empty. There's several ways to fix this, but let's focus on this comment first. Anyway, it says, "Hi, I somehow can't log into my origin account on the website." Okay. So let me talk about the website and the app for a minute, like the differences between those two. So the website is typically where you would get the app from. So this is how the application looks, like when you're logged in through the application. And this is how the application looks, this is what I usually do. It says, play on Origin anyway through the website. So you'd need the application anyway, so you'd go to the website, download it, via the download button, and, install it. So, hold on. Give me a minute. I think I can show you what I'm talking about. Sorry. So let me go to origin.com. Let me go to origin.com so that I can like show you the difference between the website and the app. So Origin. Not Origin PC. Origin.com. Okay. So, we're here on the website. So, I think you're a little bit confused or stuck, but let me show you what I mean. So let's turn window capture back on. Switch to the website. Give me a minute. Switch it to the site. Oops. Didn't mean to do that. Sorry. Okay. So I think it's minimized now, so we're good. Anyway, so I think you're a little bit stuck or confused. So basically, okay, you can buy the game in packs through the website, but you need the app to actually like install and play the games or whatever. So let me just show you what I mean. So, we're gonna wanna minimize this. Hopefully it'll... Oh, dang it. Sorry. Sorry, I'm trying. Okay. Hopefully... Okay, there, it worked. So, we're here on the website. on the website. So what you want to do is basically okay, so what you want to do is you want to go on the website, you want to sign in. Okay, what you want to do is you want to go on the website, you want to sign in. Also, if you forgot your password, or like if you forgot your like account info for your Origin account, if you have the, if you remember the email that you signed up with, then just say that you forgot your password and they'll send you an email. Okay, so let me actually get into this comment. So, hi, so I somehow can't log into my Origin account on the website. If I bought Sims 4 DLC through a different Origin account, will I be able to redeem the product code? Okay. So this is a tough question to answer, because So, unlike the older Sims games where you can just okay, so let me tell you a couple ways to get around this issue. So, this might only work if you bought the game on disc, though, and if you still have the code, on the piece of paper for the disc copy. But, this is a very tricky question to answer, seeing as once you install your game on the Origin client app, which is basically the same thing, but you use it to install your games and whatnot. So, anyway, can't log into my Origin account. Okay, so depending on how you log in, or like where you log in from, the site can be a little glitchy. Like if you were to log in on mobile, I've tried logging in on mobile a couple times and it doesn't work for me, so I have to like go through the site or the app, which you can download from the website. Anyway, okay, so I can't log in my DLC through a different Origin account. Okay, so I think you can, you just have to do this. Okay, so I don't know if this will work for everybody, but what it tells you is, okay, so what you would do is you would go to not game properties. Gosh, what is it? Repair game properties, uninstall, hide. There's like a certain thing you can do, or like there's a locate game option. Maybe let's click on move. Okay, so. Okay, so. Usually, sometimes there's a locate game option, so if you can't find, that, then, if you can't find your game at all, like, if it's, you know, hidden or grayed out, usually it would say, it would have a option to either move your game or locate game files, and you would click the locate game files option, you'd copy your game files, and you'd be able to find it. But anyway, I don't know if that'll work. I don't know if that'll work the same, but I think it's like one. I think how Origin works is like it's one couple of games or packs for how many other. Okay, so if you install things digitally, right, you would go up here to add a game, redeem product code. You type in the code. Usually it's a one-time code. It's usually a one-time code, but if you were to, let's say, I don't know, install it via disk or something, usually the expansion packs or DLCs don't really have that option, which sucks. So it's just like you enter the code once and it would already say that, but basically to fix your account, what you would do is you'd log into Origin like via the app or something and click forgot my password, click forgot my password, and if you remember the information that you signed up with, meaning like your email that you signed up with, then they should send you an email to reset your password, and then you can get logged back in. But unless you were to move your game files, like if you still have your game files, unless you were to move any of your game files, then I don't really think. That it would really be a problem. Okay, so technically no. You can move your files though. That it does allow you to move your files or locate your game files if you can't find them. So that you know it can download and stuff. And then another part of this says, after paying, I get sent the product code by email. Yes, you do. They would send you a product code depending on where you bought it from. Like if you got it from Amazon, they would send you a product code. If you got it from Origin, they typically wouldn't send you a product code. But, okay, technically you wouldn't have to, like, depending on how many Origin accounts you have, or, like, depending on how many accounts that you make, it'll be there for you, but if you want to move your game files, they allow you to do that. Technically, the code would say that it's already in use, so that you'd already have it. So you would get the code via email, or if you get a physical box with the code in it, then it would be there. It doesn't really matter how many times you install it. I think it depends on. I don't really think it matters how many times you install it. You'd have it pretty much forever unless something happens and you need to, like, copy your game files back in for it to download. I don't know, it's complicated. technically you'd still have it. So I'm sorry, but I don't really know how to answer that question more thoroughly. And then another question asks, if you can play offline, and yes, you can. Yes, you can play offline. It'll work fine. You won't have access to certain things, though. You won't have access to certain things, though, but yes, you can play offline. Like, you won't have access to the gallery or anything like that, because it needs, like, internet connection, but yes, you'd be able to play offline. Okay. And then another question. I think I answered this question, but I'm not sure. It's been a while. I'm just, like, skipping over the questions that I already answered. How do you play it before installing? It says try it out first underneath the buy button. Okay, so this is like talking about demos. I don't know if they still have demos to play the game, but I know that when it first came out, or the first few years after it came out, it had like CAS demos and build demos and stuff like that. Yeah, you can demo it, but I think that's about it. Another person said, lost your code. Kind of already answered this. But just as a reminder, if you lost your code for any reason, just probably have to repurchase it. Or if you get it on Origin, then you just have to download it. But anyway, let's answer some more of these questions. Okay. So this comment has nothing to do with The Sims 4, but I'm gonna talk about it anyway. This has to do with The Sims 1. As you all know, for most Windows operating systems, especially the newer ones, they might not come with like a certain service pack, so Sims 1 won't work properly. So anyway. Let's talk about this comment. Thank you. It gave me some fits when I didn't download the right patch. Once I downloaded the latest one, it worked great. Okay. So, this is, like, referring to The Sims 1. Now, I actually have The Sims 1 on disk. It would work if I had a proper service pack, but I don't. You need, like, a certain service pack for The Sims 1 to work properly. And I have no idea where you can download. A specific service pack. But if you have like a Windows 10 operating system or earlier that still works fine and has that service pack already installed, then The Sims 1 would work perfectly well. Sims 2 runs great though, but Sims 1 doesn't. not really a waste though, but okay, so this is basically talking about how to, okay, so reinstalling, okay, so reinstalling The Sims 4 on disk. Okay, so this is a lot different. This is a lot different from, okay, let me talk about disk installations for a minute. You brought up a good point. So when it comes to disk installations, I've done very few disk installs for like any of my games, but when it comes to disk installations, you need a, okay, so for disk installs, hold on, wrong drawer. Wrong thing. Okay, so for disk installs, what you need is a disk drive, just like a portable disk drive you can plug in, and you'd reinstall it through the disk drive, not through this, because if you were to reinstall it this way, then it won't work properly. I learned that the hard way when trying to install a Sims 3 pack, and it said that I learned that the hard way when trying to install a Sims 3 pack, and it told me that the code was redeemed. So if you do disk installations for like any of your games, you don't want to do it through the app. You want to do it through an actual disk installation. And, okay. So, for CDs, you want to do disk installs. And, let's say if you lost your files. Okay, let's say if you can't find your game or you can't install it through disk, just either move your game or click locate game, copy your files, and it should download. Hopefully that helps. Okay. And then another question. Then another question says that they lost their games, like their entire, basically their entire game library, which is what this is. This is an example of what a game library looks like. They basically lost all of their games. I'm so sorry to hear that. But basically what you want to do is the same thing, which is like either move your game or locate your game files. So let me use Sims 3 as an example. So what you want to do is move game. Move game, you'd want to do this. Click select folder. Well, sometimes it would say move game and other times it would say locate game. But if it says locate game, then you'd basically want to do the same thing. And then like copy your files, which is like Sims 3 and Sims 4 folders, and it should download fine. Then it should like basically download. I think there was another video that I watched on how to fix. So like, okay, if you like lost your games, like if your whole thing, if your entire game library is empty, there's a locate game option. Okay, so like let's say these icons are like grayed out. let's say these icons, like all these little photos here, are grayed out. And basically, you'd want to locate your game, copy your game files for all of your games, and they should re-download like nothing ever happened. Or another way, since you, I'm gonna assume that you already bought, I'm going to assume that you already bought the game. So, let's do, what, Sims 4? Okay, so let's go to the store here, continue to origin. Go to the Sims 4, and then it would say, and if it's not installed, then it would say download, and hopefully that might help, that might help your problem. Usually the only ways to fix this issue are to locate your game, like copy your game files into Origin, from what I've seen in another video, it will work fine, and depending on how many Origin accounts you make, to answer that other question again, you will have all your games, but if you can't find them, just locate your game, remove game, and copy all your folders, and yeah, that should help. So I don't think I got many questions. To answer in this frequently asked questions, but I did what I could.
Oh, sorry. Hold on. But yeah, basically, in short. You want to, if you haven't downloaded the game but you bought it, then it would say download. Usually you would download it. If you can't find your game at all, just uninstall it, reinstall it. Copy your folders, and it should download into Origin. So I think that's all the questions that I have for this video. At least I think those are all the questions,
because most of them I already answered. But yeah. This is pre-filmed. This will go up the next day. This will go up tomorrow. And I will see you